Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. My dear wonderful people, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is your brother Abdus Salam Abu Hanifa, and I will start by saying Al-Islam is honestly and truly a wonderful religion. Al-Islam is not a set of laws to be added to the existing set of laws. Al-Islam is the law where the entire universe must abide to if it wants to run properly, effectively, and to the benefit of those who live on earth, we humans. Why do I say this? Why do I always have a big mouth in saying, and I swear to Allah, I have sat in BBC talks and written on newspapers, and I have sat with really smart atheists, great thinkers, to debate issues on Islam, and alhamdulillah, always came out victorious. You know what is the motivating thought? One ayah in Surah At-Tawbah. That beautiful ayah motivates me every second of the day. This ayah, subhanAllah, is like the air I breathe every single time I am facing life. In Surah At-Tawbah, and this is Surah number 9, and the ayah is number 33. هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. In the nearest translation of this beautiful meaning, it is, he is that sent his Rasul, his messenger, with the divine guidance and the deen, i.e. the religion, the law, the lifestyle of truth, to prevail it, to reveal it, and to make it the highest upon all kinds of deen, laws, and lifestyle on earth, despite the dislikeness of the mushrikeen. The mushrikeen are the associates to Allah. So why is this ayah, this great ayah, why is it motivating me? Because everything that I see in this life, I know that there is an ayah or a hadith that deals with the issue, and I'll tell you how. There were times when I was doing seminars in the United States or here in England, and a concept, I take a hadith and I conceptualize it and make it in a modern statement. And then, for instance, one day I was teaching this course here on how managers is no longer to be called managers, but called facilitators. They facilitate the tasks of others. And this is in the early days of teaching this concept. How did I end up with this technique here, this name here, is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, innama bu'ithtum muyassirin. Al-muyassir is the facilitator. Now in the world of business and administration and management and things like that, a manager is no longer called a manager, but a facilitator, somebody who facilitates the job of others. And from that day when I preached this, I didn't know that somebody else has used it, only later to read that some PhD doctor in the United States has wrote that it's time to stop calling people managers and call them facilitators, that I know that this religion, Islam, was the religion. It has all kinds and all sorts of management. Everything they teach today is in Al-Islam. Even when I undertook my NLP courses and my psychology courses and the human interactives and dynamics and how to resolve and work on these things, subhanAllah, Wallahi al-Azim, they bring something of some PhD doctors after some research, and straight away I can see the hadith that written right underneath it or above it. That's what it is. I want to talk to you today, my brothers, after this introduction here, as the matter of people who want barakah in their lives. People who really want to derive out of this life greatness. All of us, we say barakallahu fiqh, but do we know exactly what barakallahu fiqh mean? Do you really know what the word barakah mean? Like when you say to somebody, barakallahu fiqh, in all honesty, what do you mean? Most of you have no clue as to what it means. We just say it, barakallahu fiqh, fiqh barakah, and end of it. We know it's something good, but that's the end of it. Well, actually, barakah means, as I said already once, the ba and the ra and the kaf. Whenever they are together, they mean the increase into something. The increase of something. And this is why the water, a hole that contains water, if it is a small one, we just call it hufra, a small hole. But if it's a big, wider one, we call it birka. And birka is from the baraka. And when we say al-baraka, i.e. it's the good that is in it. When I say barakallahu fiqh, what I actually mean is, I pray to Allah that He makes the good in you become more, that He enhances it, makes it bigger. So barakallahu fik, you are making a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase the good in somebody. A lot of people here in this day and age are broke. Even they work, subhanAllah, 40 hours and they work day and night. But they don't have an amount of money. If you ask people to donate to support Islam, guess what? Some people give £5, the other one £10. And I wonder, subhanAllah, what do these people do? What is going on with the wealth of their money? Pay attention. There are two hadith that being a fitness professional and somebody who studied to become a doctor for 2 years, I can tell you, alhamdulillah, the variety of experiences in my life are serving me a great deal of purpose these days. Let me share with you something that I worked with people that are obese or fat or they want to lose weight. And by the way, if you want to lose weight, talk to me. I can help you do that. So these people here, when they come with the food and they get big and things like that, there is a hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. Well, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, كيلوا طعامكم يبارك لكم فيه. This beautiful hadith is the concept where the whole industry about weight loss evolves. The hadith says, كيلوا طعامكم, i.e. measure your foods, يبارك لكم, Allah will put barakah in it. Subhanallah, ya Rasulullah. Today they say you eat portion of carbohydrates and a portion of protein and a half portion of fat and you drink water and you take supplements and subhanallah, after 1400 years the world has reached the technology of finding out when you measure your foods there is a great deal of goodness to you. This is exactly the explanation of the hadith in al-Bukhari. كيلوا طعامكم, i.e. measure your foods, يبارك لكم, Allah will put barakah in that food for you. Subhanallah, we all know there is some foods, high glycemic index, low glycemic index. Or as I call them, and believe me, I taught these concepts, if you learn this concept today, your life, my sister, will be absolutely easy, and you also, my brother, with this weight things. When I say glycemic quality food, non-quality food, there are some foods for the tongue only. I call them trigger foods. For example, cookies, ice cream. And this halwa and that thing, well, it's only the tongue that benefits out of them. For example, croissants, pain au chocolat, and all these things where your body, it is only a taste level, tongue level. But once they get inside your body, they are processed, they wreak havoc. And you eat for your stomach, for your muscles, as I call it. Meaning you eat quality food. The lot of majority of people today actually go amiss in these issues here. And I will tell you how you can take this hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, كيلوا طعامكم, measure your food up, Allah will put barakah in it. This is a concept about the food, but if you apply it in your entire life, Allahu Akbar. A lot of people ask me, Abu Hanifa, how come you've got like the number of hours like this and you produce so much, you do so much? And me, I find it really peculiar that I look at a human being right in front of me who tells me I don't have time to do something. I go, what? If you see how much I read in a day, how much I write in a day, how much I speak. My brothers and my sisters, let me tell you this thing here. In between the group of the men and the group of women, I've got like 100, 120 people that I am dealing with. Many of you send their questions to me. Do you feel that I answer right there and then? How does that happen? When sometimes I have about 16 messages. Why do these things? Because I apply this hadith of measuring up your food. I measure up my time. And then as soon as you start measuring up your time, Allah Tabaraka starts putting more barakah. When you measure your activities, Allah puts you, don't go, I'm going to run outside. Remember the hadith. If Allah is going to put barakah in a food that I eat when I measure it up, well, I'm going to measure up my time with my children so that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala puts barakah in that time. I go, okay, I'm going to spend with you 15 minutes. And this is what you call quality time. Or I am going to go for a jogging. How long am I going to go for the jogging? Hey, you know what? I'm just going to run. There is no barakah in that because you have not measured it up. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, my brothers and my sisters, put us in this life here so that He teaches us the beautiful principles of this life. Why would Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala send a messenger with the divine guidance and this religion of Islam to make it prevail? You know how it prevails? Pretty simple. Mankind study and they make a discovery. And they go, you know what? Due to the technological things, we have discovered that this is this. And then when we look in Islam, we find that law. We tell them Islam has already found out that thing there. So you see, as Islam always has got the upper hand, mankind find the results which Islam has already given the results. But does that make us smart people? Actually, it makes Muslims the most idiots on earth. Really, honestly, we are the most idiots on earth. Why? Because a kafir or a non-Muslim or somebody else actually went through a lot, invested a lot of time, a lot of money, a lot of things to come up to a conclusion which we already got. How come we already got that conclusion and didn't take benefit out of it? And then when someone invents it, you go, hey, we got it before you do. That means Islam, we actually use only what people discover to prove to people that Islam is correct. None of our business. We don't have to say people, oh, you discovered that measuring up food actually helps weight loss. You know what? In Al-Bukhari, the Prophet ﷺ said this 14 centuries ago. This proves Islam is correct. It's like actually you are taking a Rolex watch, which costs like $100,000, and you're showing it to someone and you say, this one counts minutes. Well, you are absolutely an idiot, because you're using that for something completely out of the world. So my brothers and my sisters, let me tell you something about this beautiful Islam and how Allah makes it prevalent in everything. Allah sets laws in Al-Quran and Al-Sunnah. When we apply these laws, we get results which are good to us. If we Muslims are losers, if we Muslims are only yada yada this, yada yada that, we that, and the world is working very hard at proving that Islam is correct. Normally, as Muslims, we should look at the hadith of Kilu ta'amakum yubarak lakum fih, i.e. measure up your food, Allah will put barakah in it, and we build a concept in our lives. This is what makes me different than you, my brothers and my sisters. I don't sit in inactivity and do something like that. This is why I get extremely, 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 and people who have dealt with me know this. I get extremely annoyed when I have a meeting with somebody at 10 o'clock and he comes at 10:30. It messes up my time, big deal, because I have my time scheduled. 5 minutes in this, 15 minutes, I'm gonna be with you and I'm gonna allocate 1 hour to you. When you come to me half an hour late, which means in my schedule, you are only entitled 30 minutes of my time. And then I start putting, how am I gonna deal with this person here? And with the close people with me, I get angry, and they know me and they can see to my face that I don't accept this kind of abuse when I set a time with you and you come late. Also, there is another hadith in An-Nasa'i that are reported at the beginning, and this hadith here will save you, get out of your financial problems with the confusion in your mind with time. It's gonna get you out of the confusion in your life. My brothers and my sisters, pay attention to what I say. Many of you are misers. Many of you, when it comes to spending to support the religion of Allah that you claim is the religion of Allah, that you claim you want Allah to give the upper hand, are totally a failure. And look at this hadith here. Ummuna Aisha radiallahu anha reports in this hadith that is authenticated by Shaykh Nasruddin al-Albani and before him al-Imam al-Nasa'i, al-Dhahabi and many others. So the hadith is, alhamdulillah, very good. Ummuna Aisha says, دخل علي سائل مرة. A beggar one day walked on me. And وعندي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was there in the room. And so Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم witnessed the whole what happened. عائشة رضي الله عنها says, فأمرت له بشيء. So I commanded that he be given something, food. The man took the food that was given to him by one of her servants. And the man left the house. Until now, all is good. Rasulullah is watching. Subhanallah, he's a beautiful man. Subhanallah. ثم دعوت به فنظرت إليه. I.e., she called the man as he was leaving. Excuse me, can you come back? And the man came back and she goes, let me see what they gave you. And she double checked what has been given, the amount of what has been given. At that moment there, Rasulullah, the man who is not only wearing contact lenses of Tawheed, his eyes are the Tawheed. His hands are Tawheed. He lives at Tawheed. He breathed at-tawheed. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is at-tawheed. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to her, Ya Aisha, أَمَا تُرِدِينَ أَيَدْخُلْ بَيْتُكِ شَيْئًا? What Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying this. You have a total control. Ya Aisha, do you want to have a total control on whatever enters your house and whatever goes out of it without your, if you don't know, you must know, like have total control of the income and expenditure? Aisha radiallahu anha said, قالت, نعم, yes, I would love to control what's going on in my house. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave her another concept which changed my life. When I learned it, فَقَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ سَلَّمْ مَهْلًا يَا عَائِشَةً, i.e. take it easy, يَا عَائِشَةً, relax, يَا عَائِشَةً, stop where you are, يَا عَائِشَةً, don't you ever step one more step from where you are, يَا عَائِشَةً, in behavior, not in what she was said. And she looked at him, and then he said this golden rule here, لَا تَحْصِي فَيَحْصِيَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكِ. لَا تَحْصِي meaning, يَا عَائِشَةً, do not count what you give to people. And then what will Allah do? He will count. He will treat you as you treat people. You know how a person becomes a miser? Because one day in his life or her life, he looked at what he gave to people and went, okay, instead of donating something, they give a less. And then Allah looks at them and then Allah starts treating them. I'll give you an example. Someone asks you to donate some money to help a cause, like I've asked many times. Many of you that came, from the 120 people, about 5 people came forward. Subhanallah, Allah, these are funny times. I don't know what the rest is doing, but hey, when you want to donate some money, you put your hands in your pocket or in your purse and you want to donate that money, right? You take £10. Instead of donating it away, you start saying, hang on, I need this. Okay, I'm going to donate £5. And then actually say, no, you know what? £3 is okay. No, actually, just donate £1. What you have done here, you have actually calculated, and you gave the very minimum to what you want to give, from the £10 to £1. Guess what's going to happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will treat you the same. As per this hadith here, if Allah's rizq to you was supposed to be £100, and because you've acted miser here, guess what? From £100, you get £10. Allahu Akbar, yes! Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyah says, if you want Allah to be merciful to you, you gotta be merciful to people. If you want Allah to answer your dua, you have got to answer the dua of people when they ask you. If you want Allah to give you abundantly, you must donate abundantly. If you want Allah to be Billah, cut your risk, be miser. If you want to terrorize people, Allah will send somebody who terrorize you. If you want to be nasty to people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send somebody who is nasty to you. The thief, who does he befriend? He befriends thieves. Allah punishes him. And he lives in a continuous fear. The pep talk of today is exactly as I said. Measure up your foods. Anything that you intake for yourself, measure it up. So Allah gives you barakah. And when you come to donate to people, do not count on that. And I talk here about wealth in donation. So if you want to donate food or clothes or money or things like that. So my brothers and my sisters, today is your day. Change your perception. The food you eat, calculate it. But when it comes to doing good in spending, don't calculate it. I have seen a man becoming extremely miser until he lost his family. The other day he was crying his tail off and he was angry at himself. Why I became? Because miserness creates selfishness. Selfishness creates egocentricity. Egocentricity makes you an ally of a shaitan, and your iman and faith in Allah weakens. And when that weakens, you become the property of a shaitan. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send punishment after punishment after punishment. My beautiful people, please heed my words. When it comes to food, to the things that measure them up, and you get great results. You want to control of your life, your time, and your money, measure up. When it comes to doing the good to people, do not calculate. Do not be a narrow calculator, and Allah will treat you as such. The summary of my pep talk today is, when Allah gives you, calculate and use it to your advantage. When you want to help people, do not calculate and do not use it to your advantage, because when you narrow on people, Allah will narrow on you. To Allah, I pray that He puts us under His rahmah. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. This is again your brother Abdus Salam Abu Hanifa. Telephone number 07876408735. You study these pep talks, take notes, sit down with them. This is your brother Abdus Salam Abu Hanifa. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.